Hi everyone, welcome to this series on procedural landmass generation. So just as a quick overview, we're going to begin by generating height maps using Perlin Noise, then we'll assign terrain types to the various height ranges, and finally use all of this information to construct our 3D mesh. So in this introductory episode, I'd just like to talk a little bit about noise. This here is regular noise, with values for each pixel picked randomly between 0 and 1. Perlin noise, however, is a type of coherent noise, which means that changes occur gradually. So if we were to take a slice of this noise, we'd get something that looks a bit like a section of mountainous terrain. Just two quick bits of terminology that you're probably already familiar with. When we talk about amplitude, that's the y-axis, while frequency deals with the x-axis. But back to our mountain. Currently, it's far too smooth. We need a way to add in detail while preserving the overall shape, and we do this by layering multiple levels of noise. So here in blue, we have three noise maps, commonly referred to as octaves. In red, we have the result when all of these octaves are added together. So if the first octave represents the sort of main outline of the mountain, then let's imagine the second octave as the boulders, and the third as just the small rocks. So we want each subsequent octave to increase in detail, and to control this, we create a variable called lacunarity. The frequency of octave 1 will be lacunarity to the power 0, for octave 2, lacunarity to the power 1, and so on for however many octaves we have. So if I were to set the lacunarity variable equal to 2, for example, we would get frequency values of 1, then 2, then 4. Now, as each octave increases in detail, its influence should diminish. This makes sense in our mountain analogy. The smaller the rock, the less effect it should have on the outline of the mountain. So enter a new variable, persistence. We now set the amplitude of octave 1 equal to persistence to the power 0, octave 2, persistence to the power 1, and so on. Using a persistence value in the range 0 to 1 now enables us to affect how rapidly the amplitude decreases with each octave. If we set the value of our persistence variable to a half, octave 1 will have an amplitude of 1, octave 2 an amplitude of a half, and octave 3 an amplitude of a quarter. So by doing all of this, we've now achieved a far more natural-looking mountain outline. If we consider the setup applied to a 2D map, you can see that increasing the lacunarity value essentially increases the number of small features, while modifying the persistence value affects how much these small features influence the overall shape of the map. So that concludes this quick little introduction. In the next video, we'll begin our actual work on the height map generator. Until then, cheers.